بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، وبعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أسأل الله العظيم رب العرش الكريم أن يجمعنا وإياكم في دار كرامته إخوانا على سرر متقابلين، اللهم آمين. وأسأل الله عز وجل أن يتقبل منا ومنكم وأن يجعلنا وإياكم من المتقين، اللهم آمين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting and to accept our tahajjud and to make us all among the muttaqeen, inshallah. Today, inshallah, we will end up our series that we started at the beginning of Ramadan to speak about at-taqwa, the definition of at-taqwa, how to achieve at-taqwa, what is the qualities of those who has taqwa, and what is the fruits of at-taqwa. It is a full series that is on YouTube, if anyone desires to watch it or to benefit from it, inshallah. And today is the last lecture about this subject. من ثمرات التقوى أنهم وهذه الثمرات هي الثمرات الآجلة، الثمرات التقوى التي تكون يوم القيامة بإذن الله، جعلنا الله وإياكم منهم إن شاء الله. هو أن أهل الجنة أو أهل التقوى تحديدا لا يذهبون إلى الجنة سيرا على أقدامهم، بل يحشرون إليها ركبانا، يعني يركبون على مراكب، على مراكب توصلهم إلى الجنة، مع أن الله عز وجل يقرب الجنة إليهم تحية لهم ودفعا لمشقتهم، كما قال تعالى وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين غير بعيد، يعني الجنة تقرب للمتقين. وقال الله تعالى عن إتيانهم إليها ركبانا، قال تعالى يوم نحشر المتقين إلى الرحمن وفدا، يوم نحشر المتقين إلى الرحمن وفدا. Among the fruits of at-taqwa, which are the fruits that they gain on the Day of Judgment. And we already mentioned three of their fruits, and we mentioned more inshallah today, is that they, when they go to Jannah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are all among them, when they go towards Jannah, they will ride upon a special ride. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make al-Jannah close to the muttaqeen, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Qaf, but also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Maryam said that they will come on the Day of Judgment, the muttaqeen, as when they receive this, when there is a special person, a king or something, when they come with their special cars, and like this is the way how al-muttaqin will approach Jannah. قال ابن كثير رحمه الله تعالى يخبر تعالى عن أوليائه المتقين الذين خافوه في الدنيا واتبعوا رسله وصدقوهم فيما أخبروا وأطاعوهم فيما أمروهم به وانتهوا عما زجروهم أنه يحشرهم يوم القيامة وفدا إليه، والوفد هم القادمون ركبانا، ومنه الوفود، وركوبهم على نجائب من نور من مراكب الدار الآخرة، وهم قادمون على خير موفود إليه إلى دار كرامته ورضوانه. Imam Ibn Kathir, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the muttaqeen, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya, and those who followed the messengers of Allah and those who believed them, and those who obeyed them on the orders of they obeyed the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they applied it, and they stayed away from the prohibitions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather them on the day of judgment, and they will come riding on a certain rides that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the muttaqeen, which is a kind of ride that is shiny and full of nur, or full of light and shining. It is special for the muttaqeen as they come towards the house of generosity, which is the Jannah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them. وقال الزمخشري رحمه الله تعالى ذكر المتقين أو ذكر المتقين كلمة المتقون يوم يحشر المتقون بلفظ التبجيل، وهو أنهم يجمعون إلى ربهم الذي غمرهم برحمته وخصهم برضوانه وكرامته، كما يفد الوفود على الملوك منتظرين للكرامة عندهم. وكما أورد الزمخشري في تفسيره عن علي رضي الله تعالى عنه قال ما يحشرون والله على أرجلهم ولكنهم على نوق رحالها ذهب وعلى نجائب سرجها ياقوت. نسأل الله عز وجل أن نكون وإياكم منهم. الزمخشري, may Allah have mercy on his soul, he said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned al-muttaqeen, he mentioned them on a way that honors them, which is they will be gathered and they will come towards the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let's put it this way, the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will come as you, as in this dunya, how you see the king when he expect the other kings to visit them, how they come with their rides and how they be honored, the same way, but of course it is other way, it is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said that they will not come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by walking, which is going to towards Jannah. They will not be going walking, they will be riding upon a special rides that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them, which is full of gold and full of gold and silver. From the fruits, ومن ثمرات التقوى أيضا الثمرات الآجلة أنهم لا يدخلون أدنى درجات الجنة بل يفوزون فيها بأعلى الدرجات وأفضل النعيم. نسأل الله عز وجل من فضله العظيم. Which from the fruits is that the muttaqeen, they will not be on the lower part of Jannah. They will gain the highest ranks and levels in Jannah. And the best pleasure will be for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are among them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا وَقَالَ تَعَالَى هَذَا ذِكْرٌ وَإِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ لَحُسْنَ مَآبٍ والمآب هو المرجع والمنقلب. ثم فصل ذلك عز وجل فقال تعالى جنات عدن مفتحة لهم الأبواب متكئين فيها يدعون فيها بفاكهة كثيرة وشراب وعندهم قاصرات الطرف أتراب هذا ما توعدون ليوم الحساب إن هذا لرزقنا ما له من نفاد. نسأل الله عز وجل أن نكون وإياكم منهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that indeed for al-muttaqeen there will be they will have the winning, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said indeed for the muttaqeen they will have the best return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in more than one occasion what kind of pleasure and they will have in Jannah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they will have the paradise, the Jannah of Adn, they will have the gates open and waiting for them. They will be sitting there in a special places. They will have different kind of fruits and different kind of drinks, and they will have their Hur al-Ain, and they will have everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them to have in this day. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill his promise. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are among them. وبين الله عز وجل أيضا قربهم من الحضرة واللقاء والرؤية والبهاء، فقال عز وجل: إن المتقين في جنات ونهر في مقعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر. قال القرطبي: في مقعد صدق، أي مجلس حق لا لغو فيه ولا تأثيم، وهو الجنة، عند مليك مقتدر، أي يقدر على ما يشاء. وعندها هنا عندية القربة والزلفة والمكانة والرتبة والكرامة والمنزلة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in another Surah Al-Qamar, he said, indeed for the muttaqeen, they will have jannat and they will have rivers and they will be in a place which is shows their level and how close they are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their honor and their and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored them to be their his neighbors. As Imam Qurtubi, he mentioned in his book that they will be seated in a places which has nothing from the things of this dunya that bothers us, and they will be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their status and close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how they honor in the honor way. وقال الزمخشري في مقعد صدق في مكان مرضي، وقرئ في مقاعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر، مقربين عند مليك مبهم أمره في الملك والاقتدار، فلا شيء إلا وهو تحت ملكه وقدرته، فأي منزلة أكرم من تلك المنزلة، وأجمع للغبطة كلها وللسعادة بأسرها. ولا عجب في ذلك، فقد جمع الله عز وجل للمتقين كل نعيم الآخرة، فقال تعالى: والآخرة عند ربك للمتقين، وقال تعالى: والعاقبة للمتقين، ووصف دارهم عز وجل فقال: ولدار الآخرة خير ولنعم دار المتقين. Also Imam Zakhshari, he said that they will be in a place, in an honorable place, and they will be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has everything in his hand, and which is a very close and a very honorable place, which is full of happiness and of course, how not they will be this close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will not be in this honorable place. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that indeed the one who wins in the day of judgment it is the muttaqeen, and the one who has the greatest ending it is the muttaqeen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even stated that their own place for al-muttaqeen it is the hereafter, because they will have everything in that day. ومن ثمرات التقوى أيضا وهي تجمع يعني تجمع بين المتحابين من أهلها حين تنقلب كل صداقة ومحبة إلى عداوة ومشاقة. يعني يوم القيامة كلنا يعلم أن كل الناس يعني يتخلون عن أقرب الناس إليهم، يتخلى حتى الرجل عن أهله، عن أبيه، عن أمه، إلا المتقين لا يتخلوا عن بعض، إنما يجتمعوا ويكونوا قريبين من بعضهم البعض. قال تعالى: الأخلاء يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو إلا المتقين. In from the other fruits also, from the fruits of the day that they gain on the day of judgment is that we all know that in the day of judgment everyone will be even pushing away his own family. He will be pushing away even his own father, his own mother, his wife, everyone close to him. He will not look and he will not care about anyone beside himself. And even those who are friends, you will not recognize them on the day of judgment, except if you are among the muttaqeen, and except if your friends are among the muttaqeen, then you will support each other in that day. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that friends at the day of judgment, they will be enemy for one another, except the muttaqeen, except al-muttaqeen. يعني تتقطع في ذلك اليوم كل خلة بين المتخالين في غير ذات الله، وتنقلب عداوة ومقتا إلا خلة المتصادقين في الله، فإنها الخلة الباقية المزدادة قوة إذا رأوا ثواب التحاب في الله تعالى والتباغض في الله. وقيل إلا المتقين والمجتنبين أخلاء السوء. فالمتقون هم الذين تدوم محبتهم وخلتهم، كما قيل: ما كان لله دام واتصل، وما كان لغير الله انقطع وانفصل. So everyone, every kind of friendship will be ended in the day of judgment. Anyway, any kind of friendship that does not gather you on the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the main reason of this kind of friendship, it is not the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not the love in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will turn to enmity. Except those who love each other in the sake of Allah. Except those who, the kind of friendship that they have, it is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the kind of friendship that gathers them on the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This kind of friendship in the day of judgment will be even closer and more strong than it was in this day, in this dunya. As everyone said, as it's well known, that anything that is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will continue. But if it was not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it will not continue. And also from barakat al-taqwa, ينزع الله سبحانه وتعالى ما قد يعلق من بقلوبهم من الضغائن والغل، فتزداد مودتهم وتتم محبتهم وصحبتهم، كما قال تعالى: إن المتقين في جنات وعيون أدخلوها بسلام آمنين، ونزعنا ما في صدورهم من غل إخوانا على سرر متقابلين. قال ابن الجوزي: قال ابن الأنباري: ما مضى من التآخي قد كان تشوبه ضغائن وشحناء، وهذا التآخي الموجود بينهم عند نزع الغل هو تآخي المصافاة والإخلاص، جعلني الله وإياكم منهم. So from the baraka of at-taqwa, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take any kind of envy, any kind of hatred from their hearts on the day of judgment. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, al-muttaqeen, they will be in gardens and in rivers, and they will enter it with peace. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take and move away any kind of hatred, any kind of envy from their chest, and they will be as friends, as close, as brothers as they should. Imam Ibn Jawzi, he said that whatever has left in this dunya, which can be involved some hatred, some envy here and there, but the kind of brotherhood that they will have in the day of judgment, it is the type that has nothing from that. It is the sincere love, the sincere brotherhood, the sincere friendship that they will have in the day of judgment. كم معنا؟ دقيقتين. Okay, I will mention the last fruit, and I just will mention it, and maybe inshallah then tomorrow we'll continue, we'll speak a little bit about it. من ثمرات التقوى، وهذه آخر واحدة نذكرها إن شاء الله، هم يسعدون بالصحبة والمحبة، وهم يساقون إلى الجنة زمرا زمرا. أسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلني وإياكم منهم. From the last fruit, inshallah we'll continue speaking about it tomorrow, that they will continue their friendship and their companionship when they are going towards Jannah as groups. Inshallah, we'll tomorrow speak more about it. I will give you, inshallah, 1 minute to make your dua. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are among the muttaqeen, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us in Jannah. Ameen, ameen, until the time of Adhan. You know what? Let me end. No, مشكلة خايف. تقدر تفتح من عندك؟ افتح من عندك.